Using Python in the Unity editor is easier than ever. Let's set it up, check out the example, and write our own script. I'm using Unity 2023. We'll go ahead and open the package manager and search the Unity registry for Python. Once we find that, we'll go ahead and install Python scripting from Unity. I also installed the samples that came with it. This package includes the entire runtime for Python 3.10 and pip. We can use pip to install additional packages, which is really easy. To run the example that comes with this, we'll need to install PySide 2. Let's open the built-in terminal by going to Project Settings, then Python Scripting, and then click the Launch Terminal button. Unity recommends using PySide 2, but for Mac users, you may need to install PySide 6. Make sure to check the docs as they update this step occasionally. Let's check out their example, then we'll look at the code. The sample provided creates an editor menu. Let's click Python, Examples, and PySide Example. This opens a new dialog and has the camera populated in a list. Select the main camera, then click Use Camera to move our view to the selected camera. Let's check out the code. Within our project, let's navigate to Samples, Python Scripting, 7.0.1, PySide Camera, and PySide Camera Selector. Let's check out the PySide Example C# script. Registering the menu in Unity is done with this attribute. Create or initialize is fired when the menu is activated. This function makes sure that Python Runner is initialized and runs a function within our Python class. Python Runner is a Unity class used to run Python for us. Let's look at create or reinitialize within the Python code. Here we have the Python file PySide example. Here's the create or reinitialize function. This function initializes a global variable called PySideUI that we'll use across multiple sessions. The constructor loads the layout file and builds the list of cameras. The queue list widget and the queue push button are of interest here. On line 76 of the Python file, the camera array is populated and added to the list widget. The useCamera function gets the selected camera from the list, uses UnityEditor.GameObject.find function to find the game object, selects the object, and then finally aligns the view to selected. On line 101, executing a menu item is a really interesting way to perform the logic needed within the editor. Pretty cool. Now that we've seen the example, let's check out the Python editor built into Unity. We can open this with Window, General, then Python Script Editor. Let's start by just printing something basic. Press Execute, and it will print in the box above. But let's instead put our text in the console in Unity. We'll use the Unity Engine module to access Unity-specific functions. Debug.log prints exactly where we expect it. Now that we have our amazing script, let's save it. There's really two ways to save this. The first option simply saves the Python script. But if we use the Save and Create shortcut, we also get a generated helper file in C# that creates the menu item for us in the editor. The C# file contains the Python runner, and our Python script is just as we wrote it. Let's write one more quick script. This will use the same imports as the example file, and we'll copy that log functionality. In this script, we'll download an image from NASA's Astronomical Picture of the Day API, and we'll make a sprite from it. Here we'll make the request, get a bit of JSON, and then we're going to use that URL that's in the JSON to download the image. Once we've downloaded it, we'll refresh the asset database, load the texture, and the texture type will be set to sprite. Now we can jump back into the editor and run the script from the menu. Python offers a lot of options from the packages available, which can greatly extend the functionality in the editor. I hope you found this video helpful, and if so, leave a comment if you have any questions or suggestions.